looked at multiple flare applications, and pretty much we try to design them the same with the coalescing filter, and the coalescing filter going to a liquid drain, the liquid drain having a water level in it, and it relieves all the water out of it. So to reproduce this, first I need to explain coalescing. The coalescing filter will allow the sample to come in, it will remove the moisture, and coalescing will make the moisture puddle up on the outside of the filter and drop off. So like whenever you set your beer can down and the sweat puddles up, and then once enough of it puddles up, it drops all the way down to the coffee table. So it will literally, the coalescing filter will make everything inside of there happen like that. So here is our coalescing filter. It's a 38M. You can get a bigger one in the 33M. If you want to put a gauge on the very outside of it right here to see exactly how much pressure you have, you can. I typically never do that. The filter, there's a gauge in on the inlet and outlet of the pump. We are just mainly wanting to get rid of the water. Here is your actual filter, your coalescing filter with membrane on the end of it. This is an O-ring holding this particular membrane on this part of it. This is your main coalescing filter. A, inlet port A. We have an outer port D. We have an outlet port C. And we have an outer port B. Okay, so this is inlet port. Inlet port letting sample in. So if we follow our inlet port in, can you see that little hole right there? Yes. Can you see that little hole right there? Yes. Okay, and anything on the other side? No. So let me show you exactly how this works and why. You have pulled off the actual filter part, and that is your actual inlet down right here. Here's your inlet that's going to come in. That is associated with that port, and it's going to allow your vapor, watery vapor, to come in, and then it has to force its way through the filter. So it's going to come in right here on the edge and have to force its way through the filter, and as it hits the outside of it, it's going to puddle up and force the liquid to drop off. Since we're mounting this guy just like this, it will drop off and go to the bottom, and then it will go through that hole. That hole being associated with that. Yep, that. Now, here's the important part. See that down in there? See that? That hole goes to this guy. That is your filtered sample. See this O-ring right there? See that O-ring? That O-ring will actually seal everything off and keep any type of gas being able to go back up in through here. This is going to go down in and tighten in. And seal off. This will go down in, tighten in, seal off. And then any gas that comes through the coalescing filter will then be forced to go back through this membrane. Any liquid will have to hit that membrane and drop off and then go out the bottom hole to our liquid drainer. Okay, so I need to explain that this is a tube. It is a tube, and you can see down through inside of there, and that was the little micron fish. And so there is our tube. And it has to go through this to be able to go down. Liquid drainer. Liquid drainer, it will actually build up a water level inside of it. So as you notice, no water is coming out of it. No water is coming out of it. It's gonna take a little bit before it gets full. And then once it gets full, let's let it fill all the way up. It lifted the ball inside, allowing for the liquid to drain out. But once the liquid drains out to a certain point, it stops. And guess what? We still have water in there. It's a water dead leg, whatever you want to call it. It actually will not let anything, no gases or anything, will be able to suck back up through here. We have a water wet leg in there. Cool.